Now, if you're thinking about a holiday, then you have to be thinking Evergreen Tours. Now, these guys are the absolute experts when it comes to river cruises. In fact, their latest European Deluxe River Cruise will have you waking to a different view every morning. This is so beautiful and an incredible offer. This week's special offer is a 15-day European River Cruise sailing the romantic Rhine and Danube rivers. Travel in deluxe style as you relax on board one of the Evergreen Magnificent's new starships. There's a heated pool where you can soak up the beautiful sunshine surrounded by some of Europe's most glorious views. All your meals are included and prepared by some incredibly talented chefs. There's even a cozy cinema, as you can see there, and a trendy lounge. There are cabins to suite all budgets, including the panorama suite with a clever drop-down balcony window, so you never lose sight of the famous castles lining the magnificent rivers. And it gets better, because now you can fly free to Europe return plus save up to $500 per couple. Call 1300 383 747 or visit evergreentours.com for all the details, terms and conditions on that sensational offer. She was the little girl who stopped the nation. In December 2003, Sophie Delezio was trapped under a car that crashed through the walls of her preschool, with third-degree burns to more than 85% of her body. Sophie battled the unimaginable. Then Sophie made national headlines a second time when she was again badly injured in a road accident while being pushed along a crossway by her nanny in a wheelchair. Please welcome the amazing Sophie and her mum, Carolyn, to studio. Now this beautiful young woman. How are you today?
I'm good. There's been a few bumps in the road this year with operations and all, but it's all on track now.
You are such an incredibly courageous woman. Where do you get your strength from?
Probably my parents.
How old are you now, Sophie?
I'm 13.
Oh, dangerous, eh?
So what kind of things do you like to do?
Well, hang out with my friends, go shopping.
I'm a bit of a shopper too. I like shopping.
it's good. And, just be around friends mostly.
What is it like for you, I often wonder, because I think all of us feel like we know you and that we love you, because we've sort of followed you from being a little girl and we've all prayed for you and hope that you've been okay. What kind of impact does that have on you? How does that make you feel?
It's good because, like, I know people, like, kind of know what happened to me and all. And, like, it's nice to know that people, like, follow my story and all that.
So. You've got a good positive attitude on life. Mm. How do you maintain that? You go into school, regular school?
Yes, I go to private school, yeah.
And you must be going into year 7?
Year 9.
Year 9? Oh. Right. And what do you plan to do when you finish school?
I don't know yet.
You haven't decided?
Well, I've got a few things that I, like, have an idea of, but don't know if they'll really work out.
Carolyn, mm-hmm. I have the greatest admiration for your family.
Thank you.
The first accident, as we mentioned before, and then a second accident. Mm-hmm. Where do you get your courage and strength from? I mean, what an extraordinarily tough journey for your family.
It has been tough, and I guess we still live it. So
sure.
Sophie's never far from a hospital, whether she's handing out Tara Bears or having operations. But we got to take Sophie home against the odds twice. Mm. And so we consider ourselves extraordinarily privileged to have done that, because we saw families that didn't. And it's with our charity work, it's really our way of giving back. So it's what we do to, I guess, pay back the extraordinary, talented, innovative people that have worked with Sophie.
Could you tell us about Day of Difference, which is what the charity you refer to?
Yes, it's a charity that is now working on a project for children who've had accidents. And we realised very early that not a lot of people realise that accidents kill more children under 14 than anything else.
Gosh.
And so we thought, whilst we bought lots of equipment in the early days, we changed our view in that we decided we needed to highlight the fact that accidents are such a killer. Yeah. And so we've partnered with the Sydney University School of Nursing at Sydney mm-hmm. University mm-hmm. Through Associate Professor Kate Curtis, who's running a research program over 6 years with the University of New South Wales and Canberra. And they're creating a world first in terms of evidence to highlight the fact that accidents are such a problem, and certainly for young children. And our Taras...
I'm just about to ask you, now, what's the significance of these adorable...
They're so snuggly.
Day of difference, high on Tara.
Would you like to explain Tara?
Well, when I was little, when I came home from hospital, like, a couple of years, a year or so after, I got an assistance dog, and her name was Tara. Mm-hmm. And she was, like, very good. She helped me learn to walk, like, with my new prosthetics. And she was, like, really well-behaved and all that. And then... Because, like, when I had my first accident, I got a lot of stuffed toys. And, like, it's really nice to have something to play with when I was stuck in a hospital bed.
Is that Tara there?
Yes, it
is. Oh, isn't she beautiful?
So this is to help the children when they're in hospital, is that right? Because anyone that's had children in hospital, it's an extraordinarily difficult time, isn't it? Just not for you, but also for the parents.
These are very cuddly and soft and beautiful. It's lovely to touch.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you have an assistant dog now?
Yeah, I have a new one called Willow.
Oh, and is Willow the same type of dog, golden retriever?
Yeah, they're both golden retrievers, but the behaviours are completely different.
Do you spoil Willow?
That's kind of different because she takes the stuff she's not supposed to, so we kind of punish her for that.
Okay.
Sophie, you're an absolute inspiration, and thank you so much for joining us. We really And just super quickly, if anyone wants to find out any more information, have you got a website with more details?
Dayofdifference.org.au, and they can find Tara's on site.
Fantastic. Thank you so much.